Hello everyone, welcome back. If you are new to my channel, do subscribe and hit the bell notification icon so that you never miss an update. Also do like, comment and share. In this video, I am going to paint this tray. First, for the base coat, I will take flat brush and chalk paint. And for the top colors, I am taking Fevicryl fabric colors. I will take palette and few brushes. I am taking thin brushes as I am going to do one stroke painting on top. For starting, I will use chalk paint for the base coat. This one is Cadence chalk paint. I got from Crafters Corner website. And tray is from P3 MDF Mart. For all the links or contact number, you can check description box. Now, I will do two coats of chalk paint. Front and back. Don't forget to cover the edges and sides. Avoid the usage of water. As this is chalk paint, you will get better coverage if you will use only chalk paint. Don't mix any water in it. If you want to use acrylic colors, you have to give one coat of gesso, and on top of that you can use acrylic colors. Here I am using chalk paint, that's why I have not given any coat of gesso. So as you can see, I have done one layer on each and every edge and a part is left. So like this, you have to cover overall tray. I will do second coat and will get back. So that's how this looks like. Now let's start coloring with our fabric colors. Here I am taking green, yellow, white and red color. So take out your color in color palette. As we are going to do one stroke painting, that will be easy for us to mix the colors. Now let's start. So here I will take one flat brush and I'm just showing you this in the normal speed how we have to load our brush. This is my flat brush. I will dip one edge in white and next one in red. So like this, one corner in white and the next corner we have to dip in red color. So you can do with any two colors and just do like this so that your color merge well on brush. You can take a bit of yellow if you want, but for the lower layer I want only white and red. And what I will do is I will just see where my midpoint is and I will load my brush well, and then I will just put my brush on the interval of two. Like, you have to take the length of two times the brush is, and then you have to start making your petals. So 1, 2, that's how my flower will be, and I'm just pushing it well. As this is the first stroke, it will be like a bit light in color. And we have to load again and again. So make sure you are loading your colors well. And like this we have to do. Let me zoom in. So now like this you have to make your petals. So first layer is the mixture of white and red. And the second layer will be red and yellow. You can rotate your tray overall and you can make a flower likewise. Now I am adding red, pure red with a bit of yellow on top. So this will add layer to my flower. So once you are done with this, make sure you are adding the shades on top. If you missed in any petal, as it will add a beautiful shaded look. Now I am adding black color in mid to add center, and I will use a bit of yellow in this one. So like this, our center is ready. Now let's make few more flowers. Now I will make smaller flowers, not the big one. Like this. If you practice a little, you will get a really subtle hand on this one stroke painting. And this one is really easy as well as fast technique. Now again, I will just do a bit of shading if I missed in any, and then I will add center pollen. For that I will use black and yellow color like this. So it will be a mixture. Now once we are done with this, we will add few buds. For that I will add just 3 strokes like this. So that's done, and once we are done with this, we will add few leaves. At that point we will add few stamen and all in this. Okay, so another flower is ready, and I'm adding a bit of yellow, and then I will merge them. So this was my first one stroke painting I did on any surface, and I really enjoyed, as this was something new which I experienced, and this is really unique thing on tray. So now let's make few more buds, and then we'll make few leaves. Okay, so now starting with my green and white, I will mix them together to add few stem like this, and I am creating some tentacles like this. So first I am creating few stem, tentacles and all, and then I will add leaves in it. We can add few more flowers, but as of now I am going with this. We'll add few more flowers at end. Now let's add few leaves. So that's how I will add leaves. I will tell you few more techniques how you can create small leaves. Okay, I will make one stem for the smaller flower. So you can just do like this, like just take color and press it like this to create the leaf. Make sure I'm using flat brush, so that's why I'm getting this look. You can create this kind of leaf too. You can press and you can create like that. Or else I will just do like this, as I want even leaves in every area. And I'm adding few dark lines in mid. Okay. Let's move towards and let's add few more leaves. I want one or two more flowers, and I will add few smaller buds too. So now I will add few leaf on bud area too, like this. will make few more stem. Okay, so now once we are done with this, we'll add few more stem like this, and in this I will add few leaf. Okay, over here again. And I wanted to create one tentacle, and at last we'll create few bud over there. So you can expand your design as per your view. I will add a bit of red also in my leaf, just to shade it a bit. Only on one edge, it will give a really nice shaded look. Now let's add few smaller birds, and I wanted to add one more flower, as I told you before. I will add one more on the other side. And now few birds. Okay, so like this you can see now the mid section of tray is looking complete. Now again I will add some pollen in mid, and then the stem and leaf. I will attach the flower with the mid bunch. I'm just giving a bit shading to my petals. You can choose one color from these flowers, and you can do on border. Or else you can use the mixture of red, yellow, golden, orange. So likewise you can do. Here I am adding few more leaf on the bud area. Okay. So once you are done with the painting part, you have to leave this for drying for at least 1 to 2 hours so that it can dry completely and we can proceed with our next step. Now wherever you see a blank space, you can add few leaf and stem over there or some tentacles. It's totally up to you how much you want to fill that area. If you want, you can create only one flower in mid and you can create few leaves around it. Now once I am done with the leaf, I will leave this for drying for 20 minutes at least, and then I will use a mixture of red, orange and yellow on border, as well as I will use a bit of golden. So let me do that and we'll get back. So that's how it is. I have added few dots with round brush and with golden, red and orange color. You can do the same. If you want, you can add splatters. I prefer to use one round brush and to give the dots, as splatters can spoil my flower too. So that's why. So like this I'm adding my dots, and once I'm done with golden color, I will add few red dots and few orange dots. I will not add too much of red dots as my flower is also in red and pink combination. So that's why I want my flower to be highlighted more. And you can see I did the border likewise only. So that's done. Hope you all enjoyed this video. Do give this video a big thumbs up if you like this tutorial. Share this with your crafty friends. Do check other linked videos too. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification icon. We'll be back soon. Till then, happy crafting. Bye-bye.